closed down, but there's a lot of them places are haunted down there. I've come across a lot of haunted buildings. I've been traveling down the road in the middle of nowhere, and it just hits me like a brick wall, and I look over, and I can just tell there's stuff going on in there. It's just weird.
Wow. What's the scariest thing, James, that you have ever ran into going into an old abandoned building of some sorts? I mean, were you ever so scared you just wanted to get out? You were sweating and your palms, your hands were getting all wet.
Well, I went to an old abandoned asylum in Connecticut. It's not even there no more. They tore it down. It was near Mohican Sun casinos and these casinos and stuff over there. But this was years ago before they were ever built. In the 1980s, and I went in this old abandoned asylum by myself because my friend told me, hey, this place is haunted, check it out. So, you know, my dumb butt, I go there mostly by myself. So I went in there, and I'm in there, and all of a sudden, it is pitch dark, and something gets thrown across. It was thrown at me, but it missed. But when it hit, it was loud. I think it was like a coffee can or something metal, but it was loud. I can tell you something. I just about pooped my pants when that thing landed and was thrown, you know, and then I could hear like growling and all kind of craziness. I didn't stay in there too long after that because for some reason I got the feeling I wasn't wanted in this scary place. Jeez.
Now, are you sure it wasn't somebody just living in there and they were trying to scare you out? I mean, did you actually hear growling?
Yeah, I did hear growling. I did. Now, I looked around a little bit. I didn't see nobody. I didn't see any signs of anybody ever living in there. Now, that doesn't mean there wasn't. I didn't stay too long, but I did look around to make sure because I wanted to see if there was somebody in there. I was trying to debunk this stuff, but I couldn't debunk it, and I didn't want to stick around too much longer because I could tell I wasn't wanted.
Yeah.
It was scary.
Again, I'm going to stress to people, if you're a ghost hunter or just starting out, don't go into any abandoned buildings by yourself. And make sure you talk to the landlord. Make sure you tell your wife or your friends or whoever, that where you're going. And make sure they know where you're at. Because you can get hurt in so many of these places. I mean, you can fall through the floor. You could step on something and you think you're walking on something solid. And you could drop down a story or two. And, hey, what happens if you break your legs and you're in a warehouse, you know, on a lower level that maybe people haven't been in for years? You're dead. You're not going to get out.
No, yeah, that's true. And, you know, that brings up another one I can tell you about. A haunted steel mill in upper state New York I was in about, again, back in the 1980s. And I was in the top floor. And I was by myself. And I'm walking. And they had, somebody had put cardboard over this great floor. And there was a hole in it. I didn't know it. Well, and it was just big enough where I could fall through. Well, I fell through, but I was quick enough to grab myself because they were looking at about a 50-foot drop on this jagged steel. I'd have been dead, you know. And this place was extremely haunted, but that wasn't the dangers. The dangers was, my God, I could have fell right through that floor. And I tell you what, it just about dislocated my shoulders because my 200-fat-pound butt went falling and I caught myself. I got to tell you, that was it made me rethink about things, I could tell you that.
Well, you know, I told my story to you, you know, when I took that break from broadcasting, I managed a chain of professional camera stores. One of them was an old building. Originally, it was a hotel, a brothel. The basement originally was a bar in the 1890s, so we know how old this building is now. In the mid-60s, they took off like four or five stories because they thought it was unsafe. So they whacked off half the building. But I would, you know, during my free time, because I like photography just as much as I like talking on the radio, I would go upstairs and take pictures because there was a brick wall. You know, it was bricked up, but the old windows were there, but they were brick. And they took the walls out where the rooms were, but you could see on the linoleum. And the linoleum was really cool because it went back to the 1870s, 1880s, you know, the style of it. And I'd go up there and take pictures, you know, and it was kind of eerie because it was very poorly lit. And I remember one day I walked in a different area and all of a sudden I fell through the floor. Now, I started freaking out because the retail space had a ceiling that was like 40 some feet off, maybe 50 feet off the ground. I mean, to the where the ceiling was, because again, this was an old hotel, you know, one of the fancy ones originally. And underneath me, you know, was a whole bank of what they call camera tripods. Now, I was hanging there for a while. Nobody could hear me. You know, I was screaming. Nobody downstairs heard me. But somebody evidently looked up towards the lights and saw my body hanging from the ceiling. Thank God the paramedics in the fire department got there. And they were scared to even try to get me out because they were scared they were going to fall through. But, you know, if I would have fell, you know, and the bad part is the floor, you know, was concrete with a carpet over it. And the owner was not the most, how can I say it? He was thrift conscious. So it was not even any padding on the carpet. It was just carpet over concrete. If I would have fallen, I can tell you, I would have been impaled by it with at least one or two tripods.
Oh, at least you'd have impaled yourself. I mean, geez, I can look back. I've come across a lot of old abandoned buildings that are haunted. Last year I was at a place called Gretchen's Lock, and it was an old abandoned building that's been there since the early to mid 1800s. And you know, I would have swore I seen some spirits in there moving. So I go in there, and I could see them. They were cowering in the corner, two or three of them behind this pole. And I snapped off a couple pictures in a row. And one of them, I caught the face of this woman plain as day. It's mind-blowing. And I put on one of my groups as the like the picture of it. But it's mind-blowing, and it came right out. But, yeah, I've come across a lot of buildings. And again, you make a good point. You got to be careful out there because a lot of these buildings are defunct for a reason, and they've been sitting for God knows how many years. And the floors could be falling through. They could have termite damage, God knows what. And you got to be careful because it doesn't take much to fall through a floor.
No. So, I mean, you got to be careful. Not just even commercial buildings, people. If you go into old bank vacant houses and you're walking around, who knows if it has a basement and you fall through the floor or whatever. Again, you always want to get permission by the owner who owns the property. And let people know where you're going. I mean, otherwise, you know, you could be dead. And is it worth it just to go out ghost hunting? You got to make sure that you're protected, you know?
Absolutely. That's great advice. You know, I went to another place called Barahack out in the middle of nowhere in Connecticut. And this was about 30 years ago. Nothing left there but like foundations. And I did it on the weekend, and I had these three guys working for me during the week, and they knew what I'd do, and they made fun of me all the time, you know. And I said, well, you guys are so tough. Why don't you come with me this weekend? You know, you talk this big game. So we get there. You had to park by this tree in the middle of this dirt road and hike about a mile and a half into these, you know, in the little mountains there in Connecticut. And so we get there. I timed it so it'd be just about dark when we got there. We get there, and it was about this time of year, and maybe a little later. And we could hear all kind of ungodly noises. And I mean, it was just sent chills up your spine. I knew what it was. So I went to turn around to tell the three guys. And all I seen was the backside of them. They're running full sprint Forrest Gump out of there, man. They were gone. I mean, they weren't there but 3 seconds. But I stayed around about an hour. You know, I got some EVPs, seen some shadows, all kind of crazy stuff again. So then I hiked back to the truck, my truck. And they're in there, all three of them cowering with the doors locked in my truck. I'm like, what is going on, you guys? It was comical in a way. But, again, it was an old foundations. And even those, you got to be careful because a lot of them, they give way and you can fall in. And you got to be careful what you're doing out there.
Well, again, too, I mean, you had your three friends with you. You were there by yourself. And I bet you didn't tell anybody else where you were going, did you?
No, I didn't.
See, you broke one of the cardinal rules right there. James?
I did. You're right. I admit it. This was 30-some years ago. Believe me, I live and learn. It was hard back 30 years ago to tell somebody where you're going or what you're doing because it was different then. People look at you cross-eyed and think you're crazy.
Well, you are crazy. I'm going to tell a story that you told twice on my show the past year. This guy goes out in the middle of nowhere. You know, you remember the movie The Blair Witch type of thing? In that type of atmosphere. And he's hiking all by himself, and he stumbles against these people that have a fire pit going. They have a goat tied off to the side. They got a table there, and they're kind of like going around the fire and chanting. Now, how many of you would have hung around there very long? I mean, he could have been part of the barbecue himself or the sacrifice. Undoubtedly, they brought the goat there, right, James, to sacrifice it.
Right, and they all had robes on.
Yeah, that dead giveaway, James. Something was wrong when they had robes on and they're chanting going around a fire, huh?
It wasn't. It was almost 30 years ago this, well, it'd be 31 years ago because I think it was 1988 Halloween. It was about midnight. And I got to tell you, I very stealthily and quietly backed out of there and left as quickly and quietly as I could. I didn't want to be accused of creation or barbecue or held responsible by no means.
No, yeah, but, you know, they would have maybe not sacrificed the goat and used you in place. Just think about that. Of course, if you would have got caught, you just could, if, since it was near Halloween, you could have came back and said, trick or treat.
Yeah, trick or treat on me. And, you know, the weird part was, is I didn't find out until a few years later, there was a lot of cult killings. They were killing people, prostitutes and homeless people out there in the woods and stuff. And I didn't even realize that was going on. Years later, I'm like, oh, my God, what was I doing? I was stupid, you know. But, yeah, don't you when you come across something like that, my advice is be quiet and just leave very quietly.
Yeah. I mean, and you know what? And you probably weren't even packing anything either, were you?
No, all I had was a
peppermint, you know, York, right?
I had myself, which, you know, I know a lot of stuff, but, you know, taking on 12 people, it would probably been a losing battle with the, they had a big old machete and stuff, too.
Oh, they had a machete?
Yeah, they had a machete. It was sitting there on the table.
Oh, yeah, I guess they were going to have a barbecue that night, huh?
Yeah, they had the goat chained to the table, like the leg of the table.
See, you actually could have made their little barbecue nicer that night. You know that. All you had to do is say, hey, can I take your picture, guys?
Oh, my God. I'm telling you, at the time, I was freaking out. But I can look back now and laugh. But, my goodness, I tell you what. That slowed me down from just going in the woods by myself at night, around midnight on Halloween.
I got to ask you a personal question. Did you pee yourself?
No, I didn't pee myself, right? Because I'd done relieve myself when I got there. I probably would have.
Yeah, I swear to God, if I ran across something like that and they're chanting and they have a goat chained up and they have a table there and they got that fire going in, they're in robes. I guarantee you, you know, you're lucky they didn't have guards around the area.
Oh, my God. I'm telling you. And I'm lucky they didn't have, like, dogs or something. You know, would have gave me away. I would have been in big trouble. My goodness. I thank God every day I got out of there alive, really.
Yeah, see, all the perils you go through, right? Being a ghost hunter.
Yeah, let me tell you something. That was in my young, dumb days, like 30-some years ago in the 80s. I wasn't too bright then. Not saying I am now. However, I did learn from my mistakes, and I can truly say you don't want to do these things. Don't go by yourself. Please tell somebody where you're going, and be careful of these buildings. Some of them are falling apart.
Yeah. Well, you better be. You never go in that type of situation again. Anyway, we're going to be back in 4 minutes. You're listening to Night Dreams Talk Radio After Dark. When we come back, we'll have our guest on, Matt, and we'll be talking about ghosts and abandoned buildings and taking pictures in these old abandoned buildings. We'll be back after this break.